What's going on, everybody? This is DK Dynamite, and today we're going to be talking about Black Ops 5 Zombies and whether or not the Chaos storyline is canceled going forward. But before we jump into that, I just wanted to quickly go over the recent confirmation that a contract system is coming to Black Ops 4 at the end of June. So as they officially said, we're launching contracts in Black Ops 4 to give players new ways to earn additional in-game rewards. We've heard your request for more rewards through gameplay, and we're designing Black Ops 4's contract system to provide new benefits for playing your way. Stay tuned for more details next week as we get closer to launch. So obviously we had a contract system back in Black Ops 3 featured in the Black Market, which allowed you to complete a daily or weekly challenge to get your hands on additional crypto keys. You could then use additional crypto keys to open up supply drops, still with limited chance at getting what you want. And obviously every so often there were triple play and grand slam contracts release, which would allow you to earn a weapon bribe to be guaranteed one of the new weapons in game. I believe it was dupe protected for a while. I'm not sure how that system is today, but that system overall was pretty flawed since it didn't really increase your chances at getting something you want. Instead, increase your chances at getting more of an opportunity to gamble, in my opinion. So the system itself was flawed. They only released triple play and grand slam contracts every so often. So it wasn't like you would complete a contract every 2 or 3 weeks and be guaranteed a new weapon. No, there was a bit of a delay in between every release of a triple play or grand slam contract. So it wasn't perfect, but it got better with time, at least in my opinion. But you would have thought that they would perfect that system for the release of Black Ops 4, since obviously it was already a pre-existing system, which worked to an extent, but still could have been better. So you would think with a high quality game like Black Ops 4 is supposed to be, you'd have a better version of that contract system. And in all honesty, you don't even need a contract system if you could earn new weapons for free, either by owning a season pass or by completing tiers in a new operation. So I understood why they didn't add it directly at launch for Black Ops 4, but looking at how bad microtransactions just got within this game, now is when we need the system more than ever. So I'm grateful that they at least confirmed that, but in terms of how contracts will work and exactly what you will earn for completing challenges is unknown. We obviously don't have a crypto key system in this game at this point in time, so we'll just have to see how this ends up working out towards the end of June in their next major update for Black Ops 4. But hopefully, once again, gives us more of an opportunity to get our hands on new weapons, not just Mark II variants, but the new weapons that were added in with the Days of Summer event, which are all locked behind reserves. Very disappointing stuff, but hopefully it ends up turning itself around later in June. But in regards to the Chaos storyline, I'm sure you guys watched both my video and the Gaming Revolution's video that went over some apparent leaks for Black Ops 5, the Vietnam campaign, the Aether storyline being rebooted, and the possibility of the Chaos storyline, which was just introduced in Black Ops 4, being canceled. So before Chaos, let me just remind you guys that in terms of the Aether storyline being rebooted, I may have worded this wrong, and he may have as well in his video. So essentially what we mean by that is this new version of Zombies is a complete reboot and essentially a fresh start from everything we know and love in Black Ops 1, 2, and 3, and even 4 apparently. And with that being said, this new reboot or this new take on Zombies may still feature OG Aether characters, but it doesn't necessarily take place in a new Aether storyline. So this new version of Zombies could use Dempsey, Nikolai, Takeo, and Richtofen, but it won't necessarily be a start to a new Aether storyline. There won't have to be 115, Monty, Keepers, Maxis. Those things don't have to exist in this new Zombie storyline, but for the sake of selling games and selling DLC, they may end up using their faces in this new version of Zombies. It's always a possibility, but they're also exploring possibilities to use the campaign characters from that Vietnam era campaign in this new Zombies mode. Those two options are being explored at this point in time, and anything could change from now and up to 2020 when the game actually releases. So once again, take it with a grain of salt, but we don't necessarily mean that Aether storyline itself is being rebooted, more that Aether characters who we're all familiar with may be used for this new take on Zombies, but not that it's going to go in a new direction and give us a new take on the Aether storyline we all know and love. That's a possibility too, but I highly doubt, after having an emotional ending to the Aether in Black Ops 4, that all of a sudden they'll just restart in Black Ops 5 and use the same characters and go almost in a similar direction with them going on a journey and going through a fetch quest essentially. I don't expect to see that. That would be a huge slap in the face, and it would take so much away from the ending that the Aether may end up having in Black Ops 4. But at this point in time, at the time of making this video, they could easily change their mind and say, you know what, we're not gonna end the Aether storyline, and Activision is up our ass, and we have to continue it for the next Black Ops game, to ensure that the game sells, to ensure people buy Zombies DLC, and because the Chaos storyline just didn't deliver in the way that we needed it to for Activision. They can easily do that, which, in my opinion, wouldn't be the worst thing. I know a lot of people out there do want the Aether storyline to end because they're ready for something new and something fresh. I understand that 100%, but in my opinion, from an Aether fanboy perspective, I believe there is so much ground left to cover that you could almost take another game or two to actually cover it and unravel it within a Zombies experience. So obviously people would get burned out from the Aether if they kept covering it for another two games, but in my opinion, if they do it correctly, they could still cover a lot of ground that hasn't really been explored, that people want to be explored within the Aether storyline. But in terms of the Chaos storyline, here's where things get interesting. So apart from this new Zombies experience, which is currently in development for Black Ops 5, there have been no words spoken about the continuation of the Chaos storyline going forward, which to me is kind of scary to think about, because after Ancient Evil's massive cliffhanger at the end, you would at least expect a comic or something to continue that storyline that they just started from the beginning of Black Ops 4, but at this point in time, there is nothing in the cards that suggests that the Chaos storyline is returning in Treyarch's next Call of Duty. But the only thing that was said was that whatever is on the drawing board right now for Black Ops 4 Zombies will still be finished. Now, that's interesting, because what's on the drawing board right now may in fact hold the key to the future of the Chaos storyline, since originally it was planned for the Black Ops Pass to have all Chaos maps, while the Aether would be returning in a second season of content for Black Ops 4. Now, in my opinion, that probably isn't the best route to go, since many people were left in awe after the Blood of the Dead ending, so why would people have to wait another year to see the continuation from that? We just got the return of the Aether in October with Blood of the Dead and Classified, and then to have to wait another year for more Aether maps is almost a slap in the face when apparently we are towards the end of the Aether story. So even though it makes sense to market and really convey your new story in the strongest way possible by having a full Black Ops Pass just for it, even though that probably makes the most sense story-wise, it's still a slap in the face to not properly end the Aether storyline before introducing us to the Chaos storyline. But it also makes sense to release the game with a mix of both, so that not only do you please Aether fans, but you please people who wanted something different and new. That made sense, and I definitely understand why they released the game the way that they did, with four Zombies maps, two for Chaos, two for Aether. But DLC-wise, in my opinion, it would have been smarter to end the Aether properly first, just to rip that band-aid right off, just to give people the closure they wanted before going into some crazy Chaos stuff. That's just the way I would have done it. But originally, Chaos was planned to have four maps with the Black Ops Pass, so Aether would of course have returned next season, which would have been sometime in 2020. So that was the original plan, but for some reason, behind closed doors, budgets were cut, and Treyarch saw that it was better to just continue the Aether with DLC 3 instead of waiting until an apparent next season. But with recent rumors and confirmation from many different sources that Treyarch is doing Call of Duty 2020, I'll put an image here on screen, which essentially confirms that Treyarch is looking for people to deliver a next generation AAA title in 2020, which basically confirms Kotaku's report of a new Treyarch game for 2020. So that's a little confirmation for you guys there. But with all the other rumors that we've been hearing about, it makes sense that Treyarch's budget was cut for Black Ops 4 Zombies, not only because Chaos didn't deliver all that much financially, but also because they have to get to work on their next Call of Duty, which is only over a year away, so they wouldn't have time for a second season of content. Now, in terms of what the next DLC Chaos map would have been, apparently it would have been about Medusa revealing herself to the world while our main crew travels to somewhere near a World War II battle, where Medusa is all of a sudden going on a rampage against both the Americans and some Nazis, which would have been a really weird storyline to go into, since obviously we were expecting to go to the Library of Alexandria at the Pyramid of Giza. So we were expecting that, but apparently we were getting a World War II type of map that almost felt like an Aether map, but still played like a Chaos map. So that would have been interesting. Maybe we would go to the Library of Alexandria in a fourth Chaos map, map or the final one for Black Ops 4, and the third one was just something completely different that we all didn't expect. So those are the details on the next Chaos map, and in terms of when that is even happening, we have no idea. But right now, it is not in the cards to continue it within a Black Ops 5. But with Treyarch essentially directing Sledgehammer and Raven on their next Call of Duty, they can almost pull something off where they're directing Sledgehammer and Raven what to do on the next Call of Duty while Treyarch does finish up additional zombie maps for Black Ops 4. Then when they're done with that, they could step in properly and finish development on Black Ops 5. So maybe that's what they're doing behind the scenes. But if not, if that's not the case, then it does seem like Treyarch is probably just finishing up their work on DLC 3 and 4 and the next two operations, and then just putting Black Ops 4 aside to work on the next Black Ops game. That's probably what's happening. But if that's the case, in terms of when a Zombies Chronicles 2 or these two additional Chaos maps would release, that's definitely unknown. We have no idea now that Call of Duty 2020 is in the cards with Treyarch. We just don't know. But in terms of why the Chaos would be canceled anyway, in my opinion, there is so much potential for the Chaos storyline. When did the Ether really get good? It was way after Darice, way after Varrock. It was honestly probably in Keener Dutoten when people really got invested in the Ether storyline. So it takes a couple of maps before you can get invested in a new zombie storyline. That's a fact. And with the Chaos storyline, it really hasn't had much time to shine. With the launch of Black Ops 4, the stability was awful. So nobody really enjoyed Voyage and 9 to the fullest and got invested in the story all that much. Then with Dead of the Night, the marketing was non-existent, so many people didn't even know the map itself even released, and it was a prequel to the Chaos storyline overall, so people were already turned off right off the get-go. And then with Ancient Evil, the story finally got good, then boom, cliffhanger, and then boom, possibility that it may not even continue anymore. So look at how much of a mess the Chaos storyline has been within this game. The game itself was supposed to release with Dead of the Night and Voyage of Despair. Even though the maps themselves are pretty similar, it makes sense to start off with the beginning of the story with Godfrey, with Scarlet popping in at the end. Makes sense to start with that and then perfectly transition into Voyage of Despair, which takes place right after Dead of the Night. It makes sense to do that, but unfortunately, due to some scheduling conflicts behind the scenes, they couldn't get the celebrity voice actors to do their lines soon enough, so they had to, of course, push back Dead of the Night until DLC 1 and then bring over 9, which was originally going to be DLC 1 for Black Ops 4 Zombies, and make that a launch map alongside Voyage of Despair. So, very crazy changes right off the get-go, which definitely undermined the possibility of the Chaos storyline doing well within the game itself. So in terms of why Chaos essentially didn't financially deliver, it's for many reasons. It's for too many reasons to count, not just one thing, and I think we all know that at this point. So the Chaos storyline has been a little bit of a mess. Even though the story itself could be quite strong in some areas, the way that it was executed just wasn't strong enough and didn't deliver financially to Activision. So with that being said, I don't think Activision cares about Treyarch essentially wasting four maps on this Chaos storyline. All they care about is that they deliver super, super well with the next Black Ops game, and something that hopefully sells a lot better than Chaos and guarantees a lot more season pass sales with their next game. That's all they care about. They give no shits in the world about whether or not the next zombie storyline is Ether, Chaos, or neither. All they care about is that it sells. And I think it's really disappointing to know that we may never see the continuation of the Chaos storyline after the big cliffhanger in Ancient Evil. But I would say at the very least, we'll probably get some type of comics to wrap up the Chaos storyline if there isn't an additional map released after Ancient Evil, essentially to count it as a loss but still give us closure in the slightest way possible. That will be the least they can do if they don't release those two supposed Chaos maps which are supposed to release in Black Ops 4. But who knows? There's always a possibility that they did get a head start on those next two Chaos maps after the Ether ends, and they could eventually release those alongside a Zombies Chronicles 2 or as a separate DLC next year, or maybe just at some point later down the line in the DLC season for the next Black Ops game. We have no idea when they're going to do that, but with the new engine being rumored and with this new Zombies reboot happening, it almost doesn't seem likely that the Chaos will ever see the light of day again. But leave all your thoughts down below in the comment section in regards to what you guys think about potential cancellation to the Chaos storyline. Did the Chaos storyline meet your expectations? Were you disappointed? And what would you have wanted to see after Ancient Evil when it comes to the Chaos storyline? Now, obviously, there was a lot of ground to cover with this rumor today, which is why this video was a little bit longer, but hopefully I didn't go on too much of a tangent, and hopefully I cleared that up for you guys today. But to quickly sum things up, the Chaos storyline isn't in the cards at the moment for development over at Treyarch, but that could always change come a couple more months. But the Chaos storyline could always continue to some extent in some capacity in the form of a comic, in the form of those two planned maps, or in another way that we just don't know at this moment in time. But for right now, when it comes to Black Ops 5 Zombies, they're going to be going with a fresh start and a complete reboot of the Zombies experience we all know and love with Call of Duty 2020, and we'll have to see whether or not the future is bright for the Chaos storyline or not. But that's about it. This has been DK Dynamite. Check out links down below in the description, and peace out, everyone.